went and got a new freezer. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real though. Ay, why I never saw you in the field though? Ay, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Houston Texans. That'll be taken in the end zone. That work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. First look is incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target, but it'll be second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Again is Watson. Throw left side complete. That's Fuller. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space.
Check, check, check. Motion out of the backfield. Motion out of the backfield.
On first down, Watson. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by a former first-round pick, Patrick Robinson. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out Okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
I'm going back to you.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. I call it no gain there on the first down play.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. It was a quick hitch route, and the throw complete, and they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
They'll try to run it in with Murray. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Now they'll run. Murray. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Saints have taken the early lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Lutz good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Out comes a Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards picking up the first. Well, maybe that'll help him settle back into a groove after the interception. The first drive here picking up the first to start drive number 2.
And it is just starting over, isn't it? Sometimes it's just how you have to do it. You have to erase things from your mind. Don't worry about what happened before, because over the course of a game, the good players, things turn out pretty well for them, and that's what he's trying to do here.
On first down, it's Watson. And he'll go right back to Thomas, complete again. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it, and that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. A 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a beat on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action, and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. Breeze again here on second and 10. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. It's a first down on a gain of 10. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the gun, it's Breeze. It's brought in right side by Ginn. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is so difficult to get down in the open field. They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
Throwing on first down is Breeze. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football as they've got it with a first and 10.
And now out comes Houston. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
After the interception, here's Watson. On the crossing route, complete. That's Fuller. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A very solid gain of 27. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Watson. Eluding the pressure right. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover it. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
From the red zone now, Watson. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. From 17 yards out, and the Texans have taken the lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by. He rifles one that's intercepted. Zach Cunningham with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And you don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is this horoscope off? Is biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Got a man complete. It's Fuller again. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
A 3-yard loss. Fourth down now. So on fourth down, Texan kicker Kaimi Fairbairn comes on. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at the 40. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Caught on the left side by Ginn. And he'll be down deep into Houston territory. A big time play there for New Orleans. 41 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Here's Breeze to throw. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
With that kind of loss of yards, that is usually an error by the guy carrying the ball. At the 1-yard line, you can't get too fancy there. You just got to try and plow forward and get what you can.
It's just a disaster. You go back to the 6 after you were at the 1. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. They'll try to run it in. It's Kamara. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Saints are back within a score. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
Not a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out comes a Houston offense as they get set to take over here. Still more than a minute to go, so you know, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in your confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the gun, here's Watson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by a former first-round pick, Patrick Robinson.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
Now Breeze. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts.
as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas, and it's third down. Shotgun now for Breeze. And he finds Cork. A big play there just before halftime. 44 yards.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? A guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route, well run, and the football, right on the money.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Latavius Murray, as the first half is winding down. And once again, the Saints are back out in front. Lux with the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Here we go. The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And now out comes Houston. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find it.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Watson now to throw. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun snap for Watson. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. Watson gonna stay out there as they'll go for it on fourth. They're going for it. It's Watson. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down. 21 yards.
First down, Houston.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Let's go, Big Sears.
The final shot before the break. Watson. And he'll find QT on the right side complete. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. Fielded about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. To throw is Breeze. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Now Breeze finding Kamara. A big play there on the catch and run. 46 yards.
Tell you what, partner, you get the football in his hands, just give him a little bit of open space. As we just saw, he can make you pay.
And he wasn't the top option there, but check down turned into first down and inside. This is caught, and he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. 23 yards, the final tally. A toss to Murray. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. He lost 6 there on the first down play.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? It looks like they're ready to go.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. He'll run for it. This is Murray. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. What a stand so far defensively. And now that's going to bring up a 4th and goal. Brings up 4th and goal. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. Can this defense hold them out? Here we go now. 4th and goal from the 2. Bree's going to go on 4th down. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line. He was trying to hit Thomas that time. First possession of the 3rd quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
On first down, Watson. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Now the pass, and it's into the arms of Hopkins. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Good work after the catch, going to net him 23 and a first.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays, because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw.
And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon, and the Texans have once again taken the lead. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. Ready. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Breeze now on first down. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Thomas, the intended target. And it's second down.
Young lady, young lady.
Now Breeze. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Breeze to throw on second down. And complete right side to Cook. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Breeze now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. All the yards, completions, just another play that's a feather in the cap of the great career of Drew Brees.
And wasn't he supposed to be too small to be an effective quarterback?
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Saints have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. So the quarterback drops to throw, looks over, and boom, a guy that wide open, he has to be thinking, wait a minute, this is some kind of a dream. This is too easy.
Yeah, a great dream. One you don't want to wake up from. But for the defense, almost feels like there was a bust in coverage.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Out of the gun, Watson. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Yeah, he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. 23 yards on the play. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Watson's throw pulled in by Hopkins, and he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Again, it's Watson. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. It's the linebacker, Alex Anzalone. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the
ball. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. J.J. Watt picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. From the gun, it's Breeze. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say. When you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
12 yards on the return that time, and the Texans will take over with a first and 10. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
I know I spend a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Escaping the pressure right. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. He's back to throw. To the right side and complete to Thomas. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one covers 29 yards. First down. They'll look to throw. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Eli Apple, good to the core there as he gets in and knocks it away. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guy's going downfield to catch the ball. They've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or drape all over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both, because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback, and then make sure you blanket the field.
Back to throw. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Watson going to pull back the handoff and keep it himself. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and goal. Back to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Will Fuller with time running out. And the Texans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
How many people are watching this one right here who gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this.
Yellow lady, no chance. 3 seconds.
To throw is Breeze. He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside the 30. And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Watson. Caught left side, Hopkins. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43.
One last throw here for Watson. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack.
Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark there, getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it, because we were waiting to see what would happen. Obviously, we thought something would happen downfield. Instead, it happens in the offensive backfield, and that's your ball game.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Saints are winners here as we say so long from New Orleans.
This magic with the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dreams reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing. Now I hit the scene, they like lights, camera, action. Living in a dream, now my music, they be blasting. Step out, I'm a star, always in the latest fashion. Had to set the bar, try to catch me lacking. Bank account for my son, he won't have to struggle. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They tried to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Felt like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride. For my brothers, no lie, all you can die. Never wrong, they right, I ain't changing my side. Yeah, we in it for life. When I've been up, it's magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dreams reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laugh. Hey, how could
could you lie to my face? People claim that they be loyal, they be taking up space. See my broski lose his heart when he was fighting that case. Took so many yells, I'm not going back to those days. I'ma treat you how you treat me, do you like how it tastes? Shawty, use a can't treat you like my ace. I got way too many problems to be worried, I'm straight. Me and Craig had to watch for the Jakes. On the road, this road crazy, I get 80 a show. Say my money, stack it up, it look like I'm foreign cars, driving fast, I never done this before. Get drown out my problems, let me
when I've been on this magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the Steel City at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Cleveland Browns. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
That, like 20?
You must be getting tired of seeing me.
Hey, alert.
Now Roethlisberger on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. I'm not sure exactly what they had planned for play number one from scrimmage, but I can guarantee it wasn't that interception.
No, no doubt about that one, because in their daydream, this was going to be a dream play to get things started. Instead, it turned into a nightmare for them.
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. 16 yards, a first down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Now after the run by Hunt, here's first and 10. Mayfield looks to throw. to the goal line, but it's incomplete. Jarvis Landry, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
And when that field shrinks for those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Browns have taken the early lead.
Well, you've got to like that start on both sides of the football. You force the three and out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football. All right, when you get a three and out, you're supposed to take advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for getting us the rock. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Now it's Roethlisberger. Going top shelf for Smith's shoot. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. 36 yards on the play.
Well, we spent a lot of time exalting the offensive masterminds in this game, right? They draw up these beautiful plays. It looks so perfect up on the board. But occasionally, sometimes you just say, throw it up and let him go get it. How about that play?
52's the mic. Hey, high seven.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're saying.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete.
And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Juju Smith-Schuster, 41 yards. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point put through by Boswell. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20.
Here we go. The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points.
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football. He's taken down. The sack by T.J. Watt, or as his mother Connie calls him, Trent Jordan Watt. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Here's Mayfield. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And that is incomplete. Steven Nelson able to get a hand in coverage. So possession one ended in 6. Possession 2 likely going to end in a punt.
Yeah, that's okay. They just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few adjustments along the way. It won't be exact because the defense will make a few adjustments themselves. Just get back to your game plan.
They're indeed going. It's Mayfield. Hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And now the football is going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line.
Here we go.
Alert, alert. Hey, Alpha.
First carry for James Conner. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. In for the sack, Myles Garrett. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Myles Garrett able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Well, they went with the nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, there's no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Stephon Tuitt, the one that got him down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Odell Beckham with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Browns have taken the lead.
Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one. The point after is good, and that makes the score 14-7. This is taken about 7 yards deep, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down.
44.
Yeah, check that. We're on Mike 52 right here.
Black and from the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Now this throw, it's complete. It's Moncrief with it. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Again, it's Roethlisberger. But in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. Myles Garrett able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger, open man right side of Smith-Schuster, complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Now it's Roethlisberger. On the left side, it's McDonald. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
That's fielded in the end zone.
The Browns take over.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
At their own 25-yard line.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways. But right now, you got to like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely look for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throwing again on second down. Mayfield, that's to the right side and complete to Njoku.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think... And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. But I think a Brown was able to recover, and they'll indeed hold on to the ball here. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs.
Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. Landry, the intended target. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize.
And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Credit the sack to the always disruptive Olivier Vernon.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Throwing on second and long.
Roethlisberger.
And he's taken down. Back at his own seven.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the one-yard line. Here's Jordan Berry now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick. And this kick will be touched down as they spot it inside the 45. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Hunt. Joe Hayden there to bring him down.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Mayfield on third and two. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Steven Nelson able to get a hand in coverage.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
On fourth down, they snap it to Mayfield. He's got an open man. He completes it to Callaway. But he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Antonio Callaway, 73 yards. And the Browns add six to their lead. Joseph now to have the PAT. It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes the score Browns 21, Steelers 10. Greg Joseph to kick off for Cleveland.
Joseph now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 18.
Watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen.
Bravo.
53.
Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Here's Roethlisberger. He'll find Smith-Schuster, that's complete. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It'll be a loss of one, and they're going to have a third down. Roethlisberger will throw.
Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Olivier Vernon picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Roethlisberger will stay out there, and they're going to go for it on 4th.
7-7,
7-7. Check 52's
the mark.
Come on, boy. Go, go.
You better be ready. Don't be scared.
They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. Call that a gain of 5 as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the 3rd. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't the defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
That's because you spent too much time with me. Okay, I'll side with you on this one. This is the correct call.
That one good for 10 yards, and it'll be 2nd and very short. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb, and here he'll get it down to the 7. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing, but with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Get your backs to the goal line. I can hear my high school coach right now. This is when force meets force. Got to be physical in order to win this battle.
And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Sean Davis with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
To throw here, Roethlisberger. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. And a 1st and goal coming up here inside the 10-yard line. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Parker forgets starting inside the red zone.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Browns take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. The extra point up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Joseph now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Over to the right side, caught by Moncrief. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a 1st down. Roethlisberger now, 5 straight completions here in this 2nd half, 1st and 10. Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the 3rd quarter of action. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number 4. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4.
Quarter.
Roethlisberger.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Olivier Vernon getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon. The critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down.
Where's 52? Watch 52. 52.
Hey, exit.
Watch your left and turn.
The Steelers will go. It's Roethlisberger. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. Fighting ahead at the 15. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
The Browns on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Mayfield off the play fake. And this is caught for a Browns touchdown by Landry. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Browns add on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Joseph now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Hey, Echo.
Jack 16. Alert, alert. Championships, baby.
Under 10. Under 10. 10.
No spacing.
Hey, orbit.
52. 50. 52. You don't want to go one.
Here's Roethlisberger. He's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Miles Garrett. Who else? He's in there for his 4th sack of the afternoon.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. And Big Ben intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off around the 37. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
And they get to him quickly here as he stops right around the 13. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And, my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you totally. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in the trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Tell you what, partner. After he ices down, he's going to need a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. On second down, Samuels. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. And he'll find Washington. That's complete. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
On second and a couple, Roethlisberger nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Miles Garrett. My goodness, make that now 5 sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there, hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
Now Roethlisberger to throw. This one complete right side to McDonald. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And it'll be a turnover on downs. For the Browns, good starting field position as they have it first and 10. Here's Mayfield. Caught left side. It's Beckham. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher.